Second Works, 1937. Question on G, has the meeting taken place and what is the outcome regarding the fees paid?
That 1937, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Item G.
Yeah. There is no outcome as yet. We had a meeting with them and we deferred it until we resolved a number of other issues we had to deal with first, which were a bigger priority to them and to us.
Right.
In terms of one, the area, and two, health and safety issues that we need to deal with promptly. So it's been agreed that we're going to deal with the issues first and then we're going to come back to it later on, kind of October time.
Okay. Page 6, 1938. Yeah, 1938, Heaven Field. I'm not sure about what's going on with this. There appears to be a legal dispute where we, the public, are not to know. I can only assume that we, Portishead Town Council, don't own it. I can only assume that we don't own it, and if so, why did Portishead Town Council have to carry out a tree survey and a risk management assessment?
There is currently a dispute going on in terms of the boundary, is the issue. Now, this has been going on for about 4 years. I have got the information, obviously, Sue and I have kind of been allocated for this one. We are trying to arrange a meeting with the owner of that house. They're going to discuss it and try and come to an outcome. So we're trying to push it forward. Until that's been arranged, we've got nothing else to say because we're trying to get hold of it to arrange a meeting.
Okay. 1941, what's just a correction on the minutes. At the last meeting, when 60 members of the public attended, Councillors Aldridge and myself were co-chairmen. It is now me as chairman and Councillor Aldridge as vice chairman.
Correct.
So that needs to be rectified on the minutes. Just an update on where we are. The CRC has now been created. You should have the invoice for £175. We have received letters from Company House and HMRC, so everything's now in place. Ali's coming on holiday. There's a lady in there who sent me an email asking for some information so we can create a bank account as well. Yes. So that should be done in the next few days. The temporary ramp last weekend was fairly successful. I think we had around about 90 surveys, and as of Sunday afternoon, we had 40 online. It went very well, but the weather was hot. There was more kids than what I thought would be there. But they all enjoyed it and it was safe. So, no issues. I had one gentleman come in asking me what's going on and started moaning because his view was that all those houses on Station Road are council houses and we don't care about the people that live there. So I explained that it's purely a temporary thing. Just to carry out more surveys and give the kids something to do, and he's quite happy with that. This weekend is at the Vale, weather permitting. Again, 9 till 4, Saturday and Sunday.
10 till 4.
10 till 4, sorry. I forgot, 9 o'clock, we've got to set it up. Record Works, 1940.
Yeah, before we move on, can I just say a massive thank you and well done to you and Ben and everyone else for setting that up. I was enjoying some time in Cyprus. And my friend's message to say how good it was, how it was great to see everyone, and a massive thank you for that.
That's a pleasure. Being in Cyprus is an excuse. 1942, Portishead Football Club. Has Councillor Aldridge received copies of the covenant on the land? If not, why? And if yes, can we have the info? Also, what were the future plans between Portishead Football Club and Lenton Lane Estates based on the Memorandum of Understanding. I find this statement intriguing, considering the football club don't own the land and now pay virtually no rent.
In answer to your first question, yes, I have copies of the covenants.
Can you put your mic?
Sorry. In answer to your first question, yes, I have copies of the covenants and I've also found the originals. So we do now have them all. They're all sat up in the office, locked away, safe. In answer to your second question of the agreement and memorandum, yes, Portishead Town Football Club have signed an agreement with Lenton Developments. Beyond that, I cannot comment right now. It's been discussed.
Okay, three quick ones. Cordero Civic Society, R 1944. Everything is discussed about this map, except the costings. Now, I know when Cordero Civic Society do various things for the town, it's not cheap. I can cite £10,000 to pay to get, as an example. We're being treated to know what the cost is for these things, but we're looking at more than one place. 1947 Heavens Field, again, has a meeting.
One second. On that question, that's sat with Paul Gardner. Obviously, unfortunately, he's delayed. He will be here, so he's the best one that actually can answer that question for you. I can't, because I'm not working on that particular project. But Paul Gardner can. So when he arrives, we'll come back to that one, if that's all right.
Cordano Society will want us to pay for the map as well.
No, they don't.
No, they said they'd give it to us.
Oh, they don't. Okay. Don't know how much cost it is. Um, 1947 Heavens Field, has the meeting taken place?
No.
And 1948 Horatio House, can we have an update, please? I thought this land had been agreed between Portishead Town Council and North Somerset Council under the last incumbent.
It was agreed, or there was an agreement we believe in place. However, North Somerset have come back to us and asked us if we would like to review what decision or not agreement was or not, was not put in place. We're trying to get to the bottom of it at the moment. We are in the process of arranging a meeting with Martin O'Neill, where Paul and Tanya will go and meet with Martin O'Neill, have a discussion and conversation, and then